I think about telling ghost stories, I think about sitting around a campfire, roasting marshmallows, telling spooky tales with a torch under my chin before retiring to my tent for the night. Despite the fact that isn't an activity I have ever taken part in, ever. It just feels like the perfect way to share a scary story, especially with the sound of the forest rustling around you and the stars overhead. Well, even if you're not in the forest, telling short ghost stories is a brilliant way to pass time. So we've rounded up some of the very best ghost stories we're told from around the internet that are short to give you a fright past the marshmallow. So. The first story is like imagine, like, you come back, you count, oh gosh, I can't speak English, you come back from like a long day at work, long day at school, long day at whatever you're at, right? And you like, you shower and everything, and you come out of the shower, you dry off, you put on your clothes, your pajamas, or however you sleep, and then like, before going to bed, you just get that slight curiosity of just checking out the bed, you just know. Oh, there's a monster in the bed. Like you're laughing up. And you look under the bed. And then all of a sudden you see somebody that looks like you just looking back at you. Dude, I'd trip. Dude, I'd burn the house down. I don't care. I'm burning the house down. As I should. I think everyone should just burn the house down as soon as you see something like that happen. Because that house is haunted. And the devil lives inside it. I'm just joking. I'm just putting that thought on you guys. It's crazy. But anyways, let's go back. We have two more stories. Story number 4. The chair. The short tail starts bendingly enough with the friendly seeming ghost playing with children. But when you learn the origins of the ghost and just why the ghost is moving the object around the room, it quickly gets a lot creepier. Submitted. Short story, ghost stories. A man thinks that he loses his phone and someone.